Hi, this is Gustav, the developer of TupiTube! Welcome to our channel! In this video, I want to announce the release of a new version of our software. TupiTube 0223 is now available in the download section of our website. Next, I'll tell you a bit about the new features included in this version. New features: the eraser. After years of failed attempts, we finally managed to implement a first version of the eraser for the pencil and line tools. Each time you use one of these tools, you can activate the eraser by pressing the E key. This shortcut will allow you to quickly toggle between the active drawing tool and the eraser. Regarding its properties, in the panel located on the right edge of the workspace, you will find a control that allows you to change its size, depending on the precision you want when erasing. Of course, we hope to continue developing this feature so it can be used with all the drawing tools in TupiTube in future versions. Duplicate scene function. Now it's possible to clone a scene with a single click, in case you want to edit a copy of the original to create alternative versions. This option is available both in the exposure sheet toolbar and on the timeline. Just position yourself in the scene you want to duplicate, press the corresponding option, and that's it. Dark theme. For a long time, many users requested a dark theme for TupiTube, and we finally decided to include it. If you want to try it, you can activate it from the Preference dialog, available in the Edit menu. Select the Theme section and choose the last option on the list. Keep in mind that you can adjust the level of darkness you want to use. Remember that to activate the theme, you need to restart the application, and that's all. By the way, our website also offers a dark theme. If you want to try it, simply click on the moon icon in the upper right corner and reload the page. Improvements and adjustments. As part of our development process, we have been extending and improving some of the existing features in the application. Let's look at some of the most significant changes. Foreground mode. This is an option that allows you to draw elements that remain constant and above all frames and backgrounds of a scene. This feature is very useful for shots where you need to decorate the scene edges with elements that won't change during its duration. Now we have added a new option to the foreground mode. We call it background context, and it will allow you to have a reference about all the elements that already exist in the scene, that is, in the frames and backgrounds. Previously, the workspace for this mode appeared blank, and the user had to guess where to place the elements to make sense to their scene. Now, by using this option, the user will have all the necessary reference to complement their scenes simply and precisely. This option is found in the top menu corresponding to the foreground mode, and can be activated or deactivated at the user's will. Auxiliary grid. This feature allows the user to have a better control over the available space in the workspace. Its auxiliary lines serve as a guide to distribute and align the elements the user wants to include on the canvas. In this new version, the grid has been adjusted to align with the center of the workspace. Additionally, numbers have been added to the edges of the auxiliary lines to facilitate their location quickly. Import video clip. The functionality to import a video clip as an image sequence now offers an additional option. Previously, it was only possible to import the images from the video fragment, but from this version, the user can include the audio of the clip as part of their animation project, making the final result much more interesting. Motion trim. This is a very useful resource that allows us to easily move one or more objects throughout the workspace based on a defined path. To improve the user experience, we have added a new shortcut to the Twin interface. Now, in the table where the subpaths defining the object's movement path are recorded, located in the Properties panel to the right of the workspace, it's possible to update all cell values simply by modifying the first entry and then dragging the mouse over the column of frames from top to bottom while holding the Shift key. Previously, the number of frames per subpath have to be updated manually, one by one. From now on, it will be much simpler. Bug fixes. During the development of new features and the execution of routine tests, small errors in the interface or some application behaviors may be discovered. Although they are usually low-impact failures, they can negatively affect the user experience. And for this reason, while working on each new development cycle, we embed efforts in detecting and correcting this type of errors. Beyond the new features, each new version of TupiTube includes the small improvements in its interface and user experience. Alright, that's all for now! I hope you enjoyed this new version of TupiTube and help us spread the word among your friends. Remember to like this content, leave a comment, and subscribe to this channel. This way you support our work. See you in the next video!